In this video, I would like to show the new feature appearing in ARTeMIS Modal version 5.2. The feature is a tool for reduction of peaks in the data. And in order to show this, I will use some of the pre-installed example files, and we are using this plate with the harmonic data, where we have some harmonic peaks mixed with the modes. So I'll be dragging this into the workspace and get started. You simply start the processing and have a look at the data. And as we can see here, we have some different peaks. There is some modes, there is also some harmonic peaks here, and modes and harmonics here. And in this little example here, I would like to focus on these harmonic peaks and try to remove these from the data. It might be much worse than here in the data that is not such a nice example, but the idea behind the tool and the way it operates is exactly the same no matter how many peaks there are in the data. So what I'll do now is I will select these peaks, and I do that by clicking on one of these. In this case, the last one, and then I will select from this little drop-down menu here, I will select to add some harmonic peak indicators. And I will do that by going in the descending direction, so I will now select downwards this way here. I select how many I would like to have, and I would like to have 4, and we can see how they are now matching the different peaks we have here. And in this case here, we will then click OK, and we now have these 4 indicators here locked to the harmonic peaks. Now we can try to open this new tool, the Reduce Peaks tool, and take a look at this. This is a kind of a dialog that appears here, where we have some properties here. We have here the singular values one more time of the selected test setup. And over here, we have 2 different methods to choose between. We have the good old nonlinear minimization technique we have had for some years now. And then we have this new technique based on orthogonal projection of the data. And this is the one I would like to show here. So we will use all the default settings here, and simply hit the go button here, that will then start the actual processing of that is going on in this this tool here. What is actually being done here is we are fitting the best possible state space model to the data of this particular setup here, and then we are choosing the part of this state space model that belongs to the 4 selected peaks that we have here. And then we are trying to extract the part of the response measurement that are belonging to these particular peaks here. Once we have that, we will then project the original data of the setup perpendicular onto the response of these peaks here. And in this way, the outcome will be response measurements that are blind to these 4 peaks here. And as we can see here below here, we have now done this, and the tool has processed the new data, and you can see we cannot no more see the peaks that is available up here in our located up here in the original data. So this way we have actually removed the influence of these completely from the data. What I can do now is I can accept this because that looks okay, and by doing that I will actually be able to then process this data and retrieve the modes from the data without having to deal with these harmonic peaks anymore. I did it by simply clicking this button here that saves the data now into a new data set. And I can simply close this dialog here now. And then I am ready to start processing. So I can simply run processing here again. now with the new modified data. And if I clear these peak indicators here, we can actually see how nice this data looks. There are no peaks left in the data here. And of course, it makes it much easier for the different modal analysis algorithms to work with this, that we don't have these peaks to deal with anymore. There is another thing we can do besides removing the harmonic peaks. We can in fact also remove modes if we for some reason want to do that. In this case, again, I will use the data here as it is. And now I will try to enable that I can actually add now peak indicators manually. So what I can do is I can double click on this one here, and now I get this peak here indicators. And this allows me now to use the tool to remove this mode here. So I go back again to the reduce peaks tool. And now I have to do a little modification here, because as you can see here, there is the damping here specified. And the most that will be searched for here now is having damping. They are having damping between 0 and 0.1%. This is designed for, you could say, the harmonic peaks that are typically extremely low damped. But in the case of this mode here, this one has, of course, much more damping. So we will increase now up to, let's say, 5%, like this. And then we will go down to the last of these settings also, this one called Reduce Additional Peaks. This is a very convenient tool that is can be used mostly when you have harmonic peaks. So you select the ones that you can see, but then by activating this option here, you will actually get all the other low damped mode, in that case of a peaks, harmonic peaks, also removed or reduced. But in the case of a mode here, we are not interested in having all the other modes with 5% damping removed. So I have to uncheck this this option in this run here. And then I try start it again, the tool. And now it will now fit a model that allows us to in some way extract the modal response of this particular mode here, so that we can use this and project our original data of the test setup onto this particular modal response here, and in this way make the resulting data blind to this particular mode here. It takes a little while to find this model here, and it also takes a while to do the reduction in this case here. So we will have to wait a few seconds more to see what's actually going on here. Meanwhile, I can also tell that the way this tool works is that it works per test setup. So that means that you have to select, if you have multiple setups, you have to select one, do the reduction, and then go to the next one and do the reduction again one by one. And every time you should, of course, inspect the results that they are okay. But coming back to this example here, you can now see how we were actually able of removing this particular mode here from the data here. It looks very nice. There's just one mode missing here in this case here. And again, we can save the data and we can close this dialog here, and we can run the data or the processing here with this new modified data. And as you can see here, the results are shown here. Here where we have the indicator, the peak indicator, there are no longer a mode available. So this way you can actually use it also to remove disturbing modes, modes that might disturb the estimation of other modes. Let's say it's a mode that has extremely a lot of energy compared to the other ones. It could be beneficial to simply remove it from the data and then proceed trying to estimate the other modes on this modified data. So the tool can be used for many, many things, as you can see. Okay, thank you very much.